I'm not quite sure who manages that. Just to clarify to you, Councillor Blackwell, who you've been talking about quite a lot, is the Chief of Finance, as Katie said, the Councillor in charge of finance for Camden. And he and Tom correspond by email regularly. So next up, I'm just going to climb. All right, put your website up on the screen. And so we have Christian, who's from the Camden Street Sustainability Day. One of our industrial
relocable, displaced, what I'm going to call real people, people who are already there, people who may have been there 20 years, again, making moves or doing whatever, but local people. And they may replace them with twice as many people, but those people essentially don't already exist. I mean, they're going to, for argument's sake, come on a train from Peterborough or wherever. And it's just a statistic that completely ignores what I will call the real people, the people who are already there and deserve a bit more respect, really. Part of what got us going, and we're quite well prepared now, is from the front door of my office last summer, I could count 21 cranes. Around this is happening very rapidly, and the community investment programme, we're very specifically on that, being evaluated by Smithampton as we speak. Again, we also don't know the outcome of that so far. And the housing crisis in particular is even bigger threat, because it basically gives people license to do anything as long as you're generating housing, i.e. it doesn't matter how important or how long you've been in a place, if we can replace you with more housing, anything goes, pretty much. However, we're not wasting our time complaining, we're all busy people. We're actually trying to make a positive alternative solution. We accept that densification is pretty much inevitable. More or less our industrial units are effectively single story or two story with mezzanine floors. And because of where we are and because of everything around us, densification, like I say, is inevitable. We've come up with a proposition with a large professional team of creating our own densification, but very specifically respecting and protecting all the employment that's already there, and in fact potentially doubling it. But then also in answer to the housing crisis, our densification proposal is to add meaningfully affordable housing, not just the standard definition of affordable, meaningfully affordable, which could be as much as 60% lower than market value as opposed to 20%, which is the other one. We have a group which is called Camden Sustainability Zone. There's a specific reason for that. It sounds terrible, but you get used to it after a while. And we are modelling our proposal on a community land trust model, which is important because it means everything gained by any development is retained within the community. So there is no possibility of profit going to an offshore bank account or whoever. Any gain stays in the pot, apart from simply interest on money borrowed to do the work. And in short, we believe, in fact, well, we confidently know we can build up to 750 meaningfully affordable homes, and they can all be meaningfully affordable. And we have financial backers and financial modelers who reckon that's possible, possible enough that they're prepared to put their money on the table. And retain 600 jobs, and also potentially double the number of jobs. And a key element of that is also that we have let's say a new type of architecture, although it might not be unique, where we're layering the employment space, industrial space, with homes, and we believe we can make good architecture where that's totally harmonious. It's not a problem to live on top of a fishmonger in a modern building where you can do all the things you need to do to mitigate. Always teasing because the fish smells. It says, fish doesn't smell. Definitely make buildings where that's all fine anyway. And modern buildings do smell. But again, the architecture can take care of all that. Apart from that, modern buildings aren't smelling. We can also generate a long-term revenue for Camden, which is beneficial, rather than say a developer giving them a lump sum now, continue to give them an income for just want to credit not so much a few people. Thanks, Mona. No, not really, I'm joking. We have an extraordinary pro bono team. So there's lots of people out there who believe that something needs to be done and have given us an awful lot of free time. So we have lawyers, architects, financial modelers, planning consultants. We've got a very big and heavyweight professional team. Otherwise, we couldn't work this out. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I mean, the other thing you don't mention is where you're at the moment. You've actually made Camden an offer with this money, haven't you? You said to Camden, we can do this. You're looking at Camley Street in the next phase. Can we offer you this income? And Camden are being a bit slow getting back to you, if I'm saying that correctly. We've been looking into this. Yeah, for a long time. We've been looking at community-led housing in the London Assembly, and we've had Camley Street in to give us evidence there as well. And actually, the other members of the Housing Committee in the London Assembly, when this was presented by Alex, were just like, so hang on, you can do this. There's 600 plus homes, they're all at London Living Rent. You can give money to